Mighty is your name. Glorious is your name. You're altogether lovely. You're altogether holy. Beautiful Lord is your name. Let's worship Him and just thank Him. Lord, we thank you. We exalt you, Lord Jesus. For there is none, no, not one like you, Lord. Oh, we worship you, Lord. We exalt you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your spirit. Thank you for your word. We worship you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, blessed Lord, be your name. In Jesus' name, amen. Please, you may be seated in His beautiful presence. Wow, wow, wow. Such a blessed moment again to be here and to enjoy the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit in the service. We have been looking at the Holy Spirit and prayer, a series that is very, very deep and helpful. Amen. It's deep and it's very helpful. I got an invitation for next week. Some people think watched us in a different nation. And I'm having a conference. I'll be part of the minister, but it's a Zoom thing on the Holy Ghost. They want to hear more of this thing. Amen. They're speaking in a language I do not understand, but they will interpret. Let's go back to a few things we mentioned on Wednesday and on Thursday. And then we look at what the Holy Ghost has for us today. Are your spirits ready for the word? All right. Now, we say that after salvation, the infilling of the Spirit with the evidence of speaking in tongues is the next important thing that can happen to a believer. You remember that? Yes. The infilling of the Spirit is the most important thing that can happen to you. And remember, it has to be with evidence of speaking in other tongues. And probably next week, we'll be looking more at the importance of speaking in tongues and all that. Amen? I'm sure we concluded that and we established that truth in our spirits. Again, we also said that the Holy Spirit is not for church. He is for life. Another powerful statement. God did not give us the Holy Spirit just to worship. God gave us the Holy Spirit so that we can have a beautiful life. I strongly believe that no one can walk with the Spirit and become a failure in life. With the religion, yes. With church, yes. But the Holy Ghost, and then you know Him. No way you can be a failure. Hakuna iwezekani. If you say you have the Holy Spirit and your life is not beautiful, that's why you need this teaching. To show you how the Holy Ghost beautifies destinies and lives. Amen. Now, yesterday we began examining the benefits of the Spirit in our lives, or the importance of the Spirit in our lives. Number one was the discernment ministry of the Spirit. You remember? Yeah, he helps us discern. He gives us discernment of times, of people, of places, and also of the will of God. And I remember we say this is not a mental thing. It is what? A spiritual thing which has to happen by the Spirit. You remember? The number two also, we looked at the revelation ministry of the Spirit. He is the one who reveals God to us and reveals His word to us. In 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 13, which words we speak, not as man teacheth, but as the Holy Spirit teacheth. He says what? Comparing spiritual things with spiritual. You remember that? The revelation ministry of the Spirit. And I think it's one of the cardinal ministries of the Spirit in the life of a believer. You can read the Bible the whole day and not catch anything. But if the Spirit is involved, one verse can take you for 1 year. Can even take you for a decade. Yes. One verse. John Alexander Dowie preached from Acts chapter 10 verse 38 the rest of his ministry. And from Acts 10:38, the world is yet to recover from the ministry of John Alexander Dowie. Now, number three. And number three, put a pin on it. Not that the others are not important, but number three is very important. It's equally important, but I really wanted to catch it. It is the Spirit of God that communicates spiritual realities into the natural realm. It is the Spirit of God that communicates spiritual realities into the physical or the natural realm. He will take that which is spiritual and then fit it into your heart and then assist your faith to push it from a spiritual state to a physical state. Never forget that. In Ephesians chapter 1 verse 3. I'd like us to look at it. Ephesians chapter 1 verse 3. Ephesians 1 verse 3. It's a very interesting scripture here.
Ephesians chapter 1 verse 3.
It says,
blessed be the God.
Blessed be the God.
And Father of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Father of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Who hath blessed us.
Who hath blessed us.
With all spiritual blessings.
With all spiritual blessings.
In heavenly places.
In heavenly places.
In Christ.
So these blessings are spiritual. Every blessing that God gives us is spiritual in nature. Never forget that. Even if you ask Him for a physical thing. Ask God for a car. There are no cars in heaven. Ask God for a wife. There are no women in heaven. Ask God for what? A job. There are no jobs in heaven. Ask God for healing. People don't have physical bodies in heaven. They have celestial bodies. So God does not give. The blessings of God are spiritual in nature. The one who communicates these blessings from a spiritual state to fit into your heart and then eventually push it to the natural realm through assisting your faith is the Spirit. The Spirit is the Spirit of reality. Truth is reality according to the script. It says, the Bible says, He was full of grace and truth. That word truth in Greek is reality. It is the Spirit who gives you the reality of spiritual things. He makes them real, not only in you, but to you. He makes them real, not only in you, but to you. The Spirit of God is the one who communicates spiritual things and makes them real in us and to us. For instance, it is written, by the stripes of Jesus we are healed. That will not help you much. You can read that verse and die of sickness. But the one who will make that verse real in you first and then to your body is the Spirit. So without the Spirit, the letter now begins to kill. I wish you can get that verse, the letter killeth, but the Spirit gives life. Is it John or is it 2 Corinthians? 1 Corinthians chapter, 2 Corinthians chapter 3 actually. Mm. It said the letter killeth, yes, but the Spirit giveth life. Mm. 2 Corinthians chapter 3.
Verse 6.
Yes, 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 6. Yes.
who also has made us able ministers.
He has made us able ministers
of the New Testament.
Of the New Testament,
not of the letter.
Not of the letter,
but of the Spirit.
But of the Spirit.
For the letter killeth.
He says, the letter killeth.
But the Spirit giveth life.
So you can read the Bible and still die before your time. For the letter killeth. You can quote scriptures of prosperity and still be broke. For the letter killeth. He says, the one who gives the letter life is the Spirit. It's the Spirit. It's the Spirit. The Spirit. Look at John 6, 63 and 64. John, the gospel. John chapter 6.
John chapter 6.
Verse 63.
Verse 63.
Yes, yes.
It is the Spirit that quickeneth.
It is the Spirit that quickeneth.
The flesh profiteth nothing.
Anything you can touch or see with your eyes, it profits nothing.
The words that I speak unto you.
Including the, give me your Bible. It says, the flesh profits nothing. Anything you can see or you can touch, it cannot profit you. You can die with this Bible in your car. How many homes have divorced with the Bible in every room of the house? Because the flesh profits nothing. I want to remove your mind from religion to spirit life. Carrying Bible does not mean you're spiritual. Reading Bible does not mean you're spiritual low. It says the flesh, as long as you can see with your eyes and touch with your hands, it will profit you nothing. What profits? Read on, sir. The flesh profits nothing. Yes?
Yes. The words that I speak unto you,
they are spirit.
And they are life.
They are life. Look at that verse again.
John chapter 6 verse 63.
Yes, yes.
It is the Spirit that quickeneth.
It is the Spirit that quickeneth.
The flesh profiteth nothing.
So it says without the Spirit, the flesh will not help you. Mm. Scriptures without Spirit, it is just common knowledge. Mm. It says the words that I speak unto you, they are Spirit and they are life. So it is the Spirit who communicates spiritual realities from the spiritual realm into our lives and makes them real in us and to us. That's why you need to understand the Holy Ghost. He communicates these things to your spirit, and these things become real to you. All of a sudden, there are verses that are longer verses. They are life to you. They have become flesh. It says that which you have heard, that which you have seen, that which you have looked upon, we read yesterday, that which our hands have handled. John chapter 1 verse 1, 1 John 1, 1. It says concerning the word of life. The Holy Spirit communicates. Listen, the spirit world is a mystery to people who don't have the Holy Ghost. But it is a norm to us who have the Holy Ghost. It's a norm. It's a norm. Unaanza kunielewa hapo? It's not a mystery to us who have the Spirit. No, it's not a mystery. An angel can pass and see the angel. It's not a mystery. You live in that realm. A demon can appear and it's not a big issue. You deal with it. It's not a mystery. The Holy Ghost has brought spiritual awareness into your consciousness until spiritual things are no longer mysteries, but they are norm. May you enter that realm in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I say, may you enter that realm in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Until you get to a place where you begin to handle spiritual things in your life. The one who does this thing is the Spirit. Now, please don't forget this. Anything without the Spirit is dead. Whether it's a company, a church, a career, a marriage, a friendship, a relationship. Anything without the Spirit is dead. Look at James chapter 2 verse 26. James 2:26. It says the body without the Spirit is dead, being alone. James 2:26.
James chapter 2, verse 26.
Yes.
For as the body without the spirit is dead.
For as the body without the spirit is dead.
So faith without works is dead also.
Anybody, any is a government body. It is a financial body. Is a family body. Anybody that does not have spirit, it says dead. So two people are married. I've been together for the last 7 years. But there is no spirit. The marriage is dead. All they have is a ring and a certificate. Because a body without the spirit is dead. A church, they run programs. They sing hymns. But there is no spirit. It says a body without spirit is dead. You start a business and all you know is strategy, sell, buy, advertise. There is no spiritual dimension to it. It says a body without a spirit is dead. Listen, you must have a spiritual angle and dimension to everything you're doing in your life. Otherwise, it is termed as dead and it will not go far. You wonder why some people wake up in the morning at 4 and they call their God, because they know they must put spirit. Otherwise, a body without spirit, anything that does not have a spiritual angle is dead. Others wake up and they burn things in their places of work and business premises and they sacrifice their gods. Others have portraits of their gods and they keep touching their gods. They talk to their gods 7 times a day. Because they know that a body without spirit is dead. It is only believers that you think that by being good, things will work. Who bewitched us? You know, even Paul says, who bewitched you? That we just think that by their being good, me, I don't smoke, I don't drink, I don't do anything bad, I just know God will bless me. A body without spirit. There must be a spiritual angle. There must be something you do consciously, spiritually, in your life that brings results in whatever you do, whether it's a business, whether it's a career, whether it's a family, a marriage, everything must have a spiritual angle. Otherwise, it is dead. A body without a spirit. You see, there are things that happen in the physical realm. There are things that happen in the physical realm that look like they threaten you. But if you have the ministry of the Holy Ghost and look at those issues and realize they are just issues without spirit, the moment you realize this thing has happened, but there's no spirit behind it, you don't even pray about it. It cannot go far. Yes. It can't. Because a body without a spirit is dead. Formulas don't bring success. Strategies don't bring success. Connections don't bring success. It is spirit that brings success. Am I talking to somebody? You can have the best strategy to run a home. You can have the best formula to sell your products. A body without spirit, believe you, my brothers, is dead being alone. So you can have strategy, you can have plan, you can have experience, you can have degree. But if you don't have the spiritual angle of that thing, it is dead. It will not go far. Yes. Next year, probably, if Jesus tarries, we'll enter into an election mood and we'll go for elections. True of us.
True.
There are people with political science degree and all that they will not get one vote. Because a body without a spirit. There are those who have not seen the corridors of campus. They will go to one forest somewhere and sleep naked for 3 days. And they come out with spirit. And they stand in a podium. They say, Neneni, oi! Everyone say, oi! What are the votes? 70,584. The one who came from classroom, no spirit, only experience and paper. What are the votes? 244. Na hao ni wale aliamisha kutoka ushago akawaleta wote huko. A body without a spirit, believe you my brothers, is dead. Being alone. You must have a spiritual angle. There must be something you do spiritually by the Holy Ghost concerning any area of your life. If at all, you're to have results. James 2:26, a body without a spirit is dead, being alone. And that's why Jesus said the spirit, it is the spirit that quickeneth.
Yes.
The flesh profits nothing.
Yes. Yes.
And this is the ministry of the Holy Ghost. He communicates spiritual realities into your heart and makes them real in you and then to you. You begin to have spiritual dimensions to everything you do. You no longer live by flesh and blood. You no longer live according to your age or your experience. Those things don't determine your results. There is a spiritual angle. There's a spiritual dimension to you that is causing things to work. And this is by the Spirit. Come on, say by the Spirit.
By the Spirit.
I can't hear you.
By the Spirit.
I can't hear you.
By the Spirit.
By the Spirit. By the Spirit. I was sitting with Pastor Fred and my beloved, and then I got an interview in one of the media houses, just seated there. And I knew it's not mine. I mean, is it 5-10 minutes ago? And I mean, one of the biggest media houses. So there's no need for me to mention names. Probably even they're watching now. And I said, I appreciate for the interview, blah, 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 blah. But I can refer. Why? By the Spirit. I know it's not mine. By the Spirit. You see, these things you know by the Spirit. And it's not picky, picky, punky, okay, is it time? Okay, what do you think? No. This is the ministry of the Holy Ghost. He makes spiritual realities. Things come in the natural, but the Holy Ghost is able to tell you, this is not time to do this. Or this is has come, but it's not yours. You're just a bridge. Sow it to someone else. So that I can bring a bigger thing. Is the Holy Ghost. There's nothing humanly planned. So that's number three. The Holy Ghost communicates. I think it's good to read it. 1 Corinthians chapter 2. It says, which things we speak, not as man's wisdom teacheth. Verse 13.
Yes, sir.
But as the Holy Ghost teacheth. It says, comparing spiritual things with spiritual. Comparing spiritual things with spiritual. Comparadusesh keda braskadaya. Kanasia telamayada. Korasish kado. Comparing spiritual things with spiritual. It says, these things we speak not as man wisdom teacheth, but as the Holy Ghost teacheth. He communicates to you heaven. Then you begin to have heaven on earth experience. It's a very powerful ministry of the Holy Ghost. Believe you, brothers and sisters, you cannot have the reality of spiritual life without the Holy Ghost. It's not possible because it's not by might. In any case, it's not by power.
Yes, sir.
Zechariah 4:6, it says by what?
By my Spirit.
Look at Acts chapter 1. I think I got Acts chapter 1 verse. Is it verse 1 and 2? It says, and Jesus, having given instructions by the Holy Ghost, he has resurrected. He is no longer Jesus, the one who was walking on earth. He had resurrected. But because he was on earth, he still needed the Holy Ghost. Acts chapter 1 verse.
Verse 2, sir.
Start from verse number 1, Theophilus, whatnot.
Yes, Acts chapter 1 verse 1.
Verse 1.
The former treaties have I made. O Theophilus. Of all that Jesus
can
began
call your last
both
born
to
Theophilus.
Do.
of both Jesus began both to do
and to teach.
Look at verse 2.
Until the day in which he was taken up. That after he through the Holy Ghost.
After he through the Holy Ghost.
Had given commandments.
He has resurrected, but because he's on earth, he still needed the Holy Ghost. After he threw the Holy Ghost. after he, through the Holy Ghost, gave commandments. As long as we are on earth, you cannot have the reality of God without the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
By the way, are you aware it's the Holy Ghost who resurrected Jesus?
Yes. Glory.
Yeah, he didn't just resurrect on his own. No. He says he was resurrected by the glory of the Father. And the glory of the Father is who? Is the Holy Ghost. That chapter 2 of 1 Corinthians from verse 11. For no man knows the things in a man except the spirit of the man that is in him. Even so, no man knows the things of God apart from the spirit of God. Even so, no man knows the things of God. No man knows the things of God. 1 Corinthians 2, verse 11. Verse 11, yes?
For what man knoweth the things of a man?
For what man knoweth the things of a man?
Save the spirit of man which is in him.
Save the spirit of a man which is in him.
Even so, the things of God. Knoweth no man.
Kai, the things of God. Knoweth no man.
But the spirit of God.
No educated professor of theology can teach you the things of God. We can only teach about God. But the Holy Ghost teacheth God. Even so, no man knows the things of God except the Spirit of God. And that's why, let me talk to some pastors. Even in preaching and in teaching, you know, it's not the notes you prepare that really bless people. It is how you're able to communicate by the Spirit the love you've received to people. That's why Jesus, having given instructions by the Holy Ghost, the best pastor is the one who knows to communicate by the Spirit to other people.
Amen.
By the Spirit. This is powerful.
Yes.
This is powerful.
Yes.
You can't preach without the Spirit.
Amen.
You can't teach without the Spirit. It has to be by the Spirit. And when you translate that in other areas of your life, you become a champion. You start winning without fighting. Because anywhere the Holy Ghost is involved, there is victory. Jesus said, the Father in me doeth the works.
Yes.
Who is the Father in him? The Holy Ghost. The
Holy Spirit.
Are we together?
Yes.
Somebody say, I love you, Holy Spirit.
Come
on, say, I love you, Holy Spirit. You're talking to him now. He's a person.
I love you, Holy Spirit.
I can't hear you.
I love you, Holy Spirit.
Tell Holy Ghost you love him now.
I love you, Holy Spirit.
You see, you must cultivate a fellowship with the Spirit. And these are things I'll teach probably next week. I just want to finish these benefits of the Spirit. So that's benefit number three. He makes spiritual things real to us and in us. Number four, very important. We are in the benefits of the Spirit in our lives. He is the one who helps us to use the name of Jesus.
Yes.
That is a very strong point, especially if you've read my book on the power in the name of Jesus. He is the one who helps the believer to use the name of Jesus. Can I make a statement that I don't want you to get confused with it, but I want you to meditate on it? All that God is, all that God has, is not in the Spirit, is in the name. A heavy statement. You need to read the chapter I've written, the Holy Spirit and the name of Jesus. All that God is and all that he has, all that he did, all that he's doing, all that he will do, all the power of the Godhead is not resident in the Spirit. It is resident in his name, Jesus. I think it's good to look at these two verses. Colossians. Chapter 1, verse 18 and 19, and then chapter 2, verse 9 and 10. But now you cannot use the name without the Spirit. All that God has is in His name. But you cannot use that name without the Spirit, for no one can call Jesus Lord except by
the Holy Spirit.
As a matter of fact, the Holy Ghost is not even His name. We'll get there. No, it's not His name. Lakini tunakufunza hivyo manake umelelewa hivyo. Even if it's Holy Spirit, He will come. Before they start throwing stones online, please, hold on, I'm coming. Chapter what?
Colossians chapter 1.
Chapter 1.
Yes.
Look at it, Colossians chapter 1.
Colossians chapter 1, verse 18.
Verse 18.
And He is the head of the body.
He is the head of the body.
The church.
The church.
Who is the beginning?
Who is the beginning?
The firstborn from the dead.
Uh-huh.
That in all things
he may have the preeminence. Look at verse 19.
For it pleased the Father.
This is for it pleased the Father.
That in Him,
in Christ,
should all fullness dwell.
Mm.
Yes.
It pleased the Father that all the fullness of the Godhead is not in the Spirit, is in Christ. Let's go deeper. Chapter 2, verse 10. Colossians.
Colossians chapter 2, verse 10.
Uh-huh.
You start from verse 9, sir?
Verse 9, okay. All right.
Verse 9. For in Him,
Colossians 2, 9, for in Him
dwelleth all the fullness of the Godhead.
All the fullness.
Bodily.
All the fullness. All the fullness. All the fullness of the Godhead. He says it is in Christ bodily.
Yes.
Not in the Spirit. Is it Romans? I wish you can get that verse that says, in Him and for Him and through Him are all things. Is Romans chapter what?
Chapter 11.
You know where it is? Romans chapter 11, yes, yes. Romans chapter 11, verse what?
Verse 36.
Romans 11, verse 36. Look at this verse. It's very powerful. Romans 11, 36. Yes, yes, sir.
For of Him.
For of Him.
And through Him.
And through Him.
And to Him.
And to Him.
Are all things.
Abba. Oh, yeah. Romans 11, 36.
Yes, sir.
Listen to this verse again. Yes, sir.
For of Him.
For of Him. This is Christ. For of Him.
And through Him.
And through Him.
And to Him.
And to Him.
Are all things.
So Christ is the end of all disputes.
Yes.
He is the fullness of all in all. Not the Spirit. But you cannot remove the Spirit because He's the one who represents Christ on earth. Now, what is the name of the Holy Ghost? Because Holy Spirit is not a name. It's a spirit that is holy. It's only put the article there, Holy Ghost, that is specified. But we also have other spirits. The Bible says the spirits of just men made perfect. The Holy Ghost, He is the one who answers to the name Jesus. Anytime you say Jesus, He is the one who, He is the power behind that name. Hey, I'm appending someone's theology here. You thought the power is in the Spirit. No, the power is in Christ.
Amen.
Christ is the center of power.
Amen.
For He is the express image of His person. The fullness of all in all.
Yes.
But the Spirit is the one who is communicating that power on earth. Now, look at this. I'm sure we're getting blessed online, right? Are you catching this thing?
Yes.
It's very deep.
Yes, yes.
All right, look at this. Let's look at how Jesus sent us. Let's go to Mark chapter what? Chapter 16. Let's start Mark chapter 16, verse 15. Mark 16. Are you getting blessed?
Yes.
I hope you're not getting confused. You need to understand who is the Holy Ghost. And that's why the Holy Ghost has no message. His message is Christ. His message is Christ. Now, let's take a good example. Mark 16:15, sir. What does it say?
Mark chapter 16, verse 15.
Yes, yes.
And he said unto them,
what did he say?
Go ye into all the world.
Go ye into all the world.
And preach the gospel to every
preach
creature.
Preach to every creature.
He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved.
And is baptized shall be saved.
But he that believeth not shall be damned.
Uh-huh.
Verse 17. And these signs shall follow them that believe.
Now look at this. These signs shall follow them that believe.
In my name.
He didn't say in my spirit. It says in my name. You shall do this. You shall do that. You shall do this, you shall do that, and lo, I will be with you always. It didn't say in my spirit. Yes. It says in my name. Why? Christ is the center of power. Amen. Glory. For it pleased the Father that in him should all the fullness dwell bodily. That's why you cannot know the Spirit without knowing Christ. And you cannot know Christ without knowing the Spirit. That's why I've said benefit number four is the one who helps us use the name. God's power is resident in his name. Now forget that. Not the Spirit. But you cannot use the name without the Spirit. I think it's good we just settle this case. 1 Corinthians chapter 12. Verse 3, nobody can call Jesus Lord except by the Spirit. It is when you say Jesus by the Spirit that power is made available. Because Christ is the center. Don't forget that Christ is the center of all power. Christ is the center. He is the fullness of all. For unto him and through him and for him are all things. But look, let's take 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 3.
First Corinthians chapter 12, verse 3.
Uh-huh.
Wherefore I give you to understand.
I give you to understand.
That no man speaketh by the Spirit
no
of God.
No man speaking by the Spirit of God.
Calleth Jesus accursed.
Uh-huh.
And that no man can say that
no
Jesus is the Lord.
No man can say Jesus is Lord.
But by the
but
Holy
by
Ghost.
You cannot call that name without the Holy Ghost. So he's the one who helps the believer to use the name appropriately and effectively. When you say Jesus, the one who answers is the Spirit. So when you say Jesus, you're saying Holy Ghost. When you say Holy Ghost, you're saying Jesus. I want to teach you these things so that you become effective in your Christian walk. Brothers and sisters, when I learned these truths, spiritual warfare became a game to me. These things are real because now you even understand the Holy Ghost better. You're no longer guessing. You stop the nonsense of sending the Holy Ghost to do things. His work is to empower you to do them. Jesus said, you shall heal the sick. You, not the Holy Ghost. He said, in my name, you shall heal the sick. In my name, you shall lay hands. In my name, you shall do this. In my name, you shall speak with new tongues. You are the subject. I wish you know how important you are before God. God is counting on us to save the world. Can I be honest with you? Listen to this. We were discussing something about eschatology with Pastor Fred, and I hope and I pray that you prepare. Have you told him?
Yes.
You make sure. I want to host you. Yes. You talk to me about this end time thing. I don't understand it well, but it seems you people are my teachers. You know, Pastor Fred and Pastor Rufus, imambo ya end time. Where? My friend, they make me look like a child. I can know teacher sana because of the mantle.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
They have the knowledge, I have the mantle. But do you know we, the church, can delay the appearing of the Antichrist? Because the Bible says we are the salt of the earth. Yes. We are the ones who preserve the earth. If believers can rise up with the ministry of the Holy Ghost and use the name of Jesus appropriately, the Antichrist will not appear. Amen. It will take until we finish our job. Yes. For example, there's an issue in your office. So-and-so is fighting you. So-and-so na kuchimba. I mean, things are happening in your office. Look at the nonsense. You go to report them to the Holy Spirit. Oh, Holy Spirit, you can see Mr. Wanaina is disturbing me. Oh, Holy Spirit, Mr. Wanaina, do something with Mr. Wanaina. Holy Ghost does not know Wanaina. It says, behold, I give you power. You believer, you are the one to say, in the name of Jesus, any Haman, any Pharaoh, any Herod in my office, I uproot you. And when you say Jesus, by the Spirit, the Holy Ghost goes into action and something happens in the physical. Why? Jesus is the center of all power. Usia is how you are in your life. It's not the Spirit. Jesus is the center of all power. The Holy Ghost is the one who communicates that power to us on earth. For it pleased the Father that in Him should all the fullness dwell in Christ. In Christ. The Holy Ghost does not have any message. His message is Christ. Yes. Okay, let's go deeper. Chapter 16 of John. Look at how the Holy Ghost, Jesus said about the Spirit. Mm. Yes. These truths, you can't understand them mentally. They are spiritually discerned.
Yes.
When you say, okay, so the name Jesus, Holy Ghost, Jesus, Jesus, Holy Ghost, unaribu, utachanganikiwa. Just open your spirit. Let revelation enter and you shall be free. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
I've gotten to a place whereby I can manifest the kingdom anywhere I go as long as the Spirit gives me permission. Because I know where to press. Power is in the name. The altars nowadays, I enter and I ask, do I preach or do I manifest? Mm. It's not that, hey, nasikia the Spirit, nasikia the, no, uko tulitoka. Paul put it this way, I long to see you. Yes. That I may impart. Mm. There is something I want to give you. I, Paul, I have it. It says, I labros kesh kobria da kaske. It says, I long to see Romans 1:11 that I may impart some spiritual gifts unto you. There's something I have, I want to give it to you. That is somebody who has understood the ministry of the Spirit, the power in the name, and the fellowship of the word. Hallelujah. These are truths that will change your life. Can I be honest with you?
Yes.
These 10 days are the best days this year. If you just take these teachings deeply and listen to this podcast over again until these truths become a part of you. I'm sharing you the secrets that have made me who I am today. Amen. The Spirit. Hallelujah. The Spirit. Amen. The Spirit. On our way to Kinshasa, when they picked me from my house, I entered the car and there was an agency. I said, drive very fast. I need to get the airport. And we were very early. True or false? We were very early. But there was an urgency. I said, drive very fast. We got to the airport. In fact, my car was the first one to get the airport. My driver, security, got me out, blah, 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 blah. Went to check in. As soon as I just checked in like this, I turned back and I saw Apostle Mokadi, also checking in. Surely, life is spirit. Life is spirit. Life is spirit. The other day we were going to Nigeria. We changed ticket 3 times. By the Spirit. Not knowing that when I checked in, Bishop Q and also were together in the same queue. Ah, what is it? It's not guesswork. The line, how am I greeted? talked a few minutes here. Then I told my son, can you see how the Spirit works? You know, Ikitu is not guesswork. You just have to know how to walk with the Spirit. Am I talking to somebody? But can I be honest with us? Oh, please, allow me to say this. Online, allow me to say this. Please, catch this. Never forget it. These things I'm teaching about the Spirit, they will not take root in your heart until you understand Christ is the center of power. The moment you settle that Christ is the center of power, in Him lies all the fullness, then there is an understanding that will come to your heart about the Spirit that has never been there. Because now you are in line with spiritual laws by the Spirit. By the Spirit. How I pray you may understand these realities. They have made my life very beautiful. If I'm to cast out demons now here, you'll be very surprised. I laid hands on somebody yesterday. Impromptu. It was not even planned. And I said, I just broke the patterns of the fathers and mothers. So it was no plan. It was nothing. It wasn't even in my mind. I just later said, patterns of your father's house. That lady called me today. She told me she has slept like a baby for the first time after many, many, many weeks or days. Slept like a baby. I'm sure she's watching now. She said, when I laid hands on her, she felt heat. And she started crying. So I asked her, why were you crying? She said, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. Man of God, I don't know. So she asked, did you plan to lay hands? I said, there was no plan, nothing. By the Spirit. Why? Nielewe hapa, my heart understands Christ is the center of power. Hiyo kitu lazima kuingie. You have to understand that it pleased the Father that in Him, that is in Christ, is the fullness of all. Once your spirit receives that as truth, another dimension of the Spirit will open up to you. There is an understanding that will come to you that has never been there. Why? You have accepted reality in your heart. Power is not in the Spirit. Power is in Christ. The Spirit is the administrator of that power. It is in His office to administrate Christ to us. So that's why you cannot say, okay, from today, it's just the name of Jesus. No, 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 no. You can't do that. Again, you can't say, it's the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost. Holy Spirit come. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. He will ask you, where is the power? He cannot work in our lives without Christ. His work is to authenticate the name on earth. That's why He does not have a message. Let's go to that John chapter 16. The Holy Ghost does not have a message. The message He has is Christ. Are you catching the flow? That's why you can be full of the Holy Ghost, but demons still attack you. Why? He can't walk until you use Christ. You have to speak Jesus for the Holy Ghost to walk. John chapter 16. We start from verse 13 or from verse what?
Yes, verse 13, sir.
From verse 13. John 16, 13. Yes, yes.
John 16, 13.
Uh-huh.
Howbeit when the Spirit of truth
when
is come.
When the Spirit of truth is come.
He will guide you into all truth.
He will guide you into all truth.
For He shall not speak of Himself.
He shall not speak of Himself.
But whatsoever He shall hear.
Did you get that one? He does not have a message. That's why even His name, there is no name to the Holy Ghost. It's called Holy Spirit. It's the Spirit of the Father. The Bible calls Him the one that proceeds from the Father. Look at that verse again, verse 13, sir.
John 16:13. Howbeit, when the Spirit of truth is come, he will guide you into all truth.
He will guide you into all truth. Remember the revelation ministry of the Spirit?
Yes.
Is there? Yes, yes, yes.
For he shall not speak of himself.
So the Holy Ghost is not truth. He is a guider to truth.
Yes.
Who is truth? Christ Jesus. Jesus said, I am the way. I am the truth.
The life.
I am the life. Glory to God. The Holy Ghost is not the truth. He leads you to the truth. It says he shall not speak of himself. He will guide you into all truth. Yes. For he shall not speak of himself.
But whatsoever he shall hear.
Whatsoever, you see, he does not have a message. Whatsoever he shall hear. From who?
From Christ.
From Christ. Because Christ is the word. I'm thinking of repeating this thing tomorrow. Tomorrow there's no service. Or on baby Sunday, Monday. Are we together?
Yes.
Church, are we together? Yes. Online, are they at home or they're asking questions? Online, you're lifted for life. Are you there?
Yes.
Are you catching the flow? You see, the Bible says, he shall not speak of himself. But whatsoever he shall hear,
that shall he speak.
That shall he speak.
And he will show you things.
Remember, he shall show you the discerning ministry of the Spirit. He shall show you things to come. So the Holy Ghost, when you say Jesus, he's the one who appears. That number four benefit of the Spirit is a very important key. He helps us use the name of Jesus appropriately and effectively. Because there's a power behind that name. Appropriately and effectively. One day, Papa Hagin had an experience with God. According to him, he says Jesus appeared. And when Jesus appeared, Jesus was talking to him. And then a demon came in between him and Jesus. And the demon was distracting him. Yaki, yaki, yaka, yaki, 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 penya, penya, yaki, in the presence of the Lord. And the Lord could do nothing. So Kenneth Hagin says, he wondered, how could this nonsense be playing here? And Jesus is here. The Holy Ghost also was there because there is no way he will see Jesus or the Spirit. Because it is the Spirit that reveals Christ. But the demons were there. That's why you can speak in tongues and be cursed. Oh yes. You can speak in tongues and be under an influence of a curse. Let me put it that way for those. Kuna wale akili inawasumbua kidogo hapo. So you can speak in tongues and still be under the influence of a curse. Demons, they played. Hagin could not hear. It got to a place whereby he wondered, I can't even hear what Jesus is saying. And then Jesus kept talking. Didn't even concern himself with the demon. Then Hagin said, in the name of Jesus. Then the demon fell. Pia! And then Jesus was still talking. Never discussed about the demon. No. Kidogo, the demon woke up again. Yaki, yaki. He said, what is this now? Then he said, in the name. Now he met it from his heart. And the demon left. And then Jesus told him, had you not done nothing about it, I could not have done anything about it. You see, the name is Christ. Let me put it this way. Christ and his name, they are one. Who he was when he was on earth is what his name is on our lips today. Who he was when he was on earth is what his name is on the lips of a believer. What he did 2,000 plus years ago is what his name can do today on the lips of a believer. But for that name to work, it needs the Spirit. That's why you cannot use the name without Jesus. without the Holy Ghost. And the Holy Ghost cannot effectively help you without the name. Amen. Power is in the name of Jesus. The Holy Ghost is the administrator of that power on earth. So anybody can say Jesus, Jesus, but not everyone can say Jesus with results. The day you understand the supremacy of the name of Jesus, you will know how small demons are. I've gotten to a place, and heaven is my witness, where if a demon visits me in the night, I wake up. I wake up. Naamkanga. And most of the times, I answer them in the dream. So what nonsense is this? You can't do it. Ask heaven. But do you know, it happened this way. The moment this understanding entered my heart, the moment I understood, oh, so Christ is the fullness of all. He is the center of all. For it pleased the Father that in him, that in him, that understanding, I want to repeat it until it enters your heart. It will begin to deal with curses in your foundation automatically. Something will just happen to your realm. There is a confidence that will enter your heart that has never been there. By just understanding that Christ is the center of power. And I'm in him. And then verse 10, it says, he is the head. Look at it, Colossians 2, 9 and 10. He's not only the center, but he's also the head of all principality and power. Okay.
Yes.
The wonders that will take place in your life with this understanding are unmatchable. Look at Colossians 2, verse 9.
Colossians chapter 2, verse 9.
Continue, sir.
For in him dwelleth all the fullness of the Godhead bodily.
Dwelleth all the fullness
of the Godhead.
Of the Godhead
bodily.
Continue, sir.
Verse 10. And ye are complete in him.
He says, and ye are complete in him.
Which is the head of all principality and power.
I am complete in Christ. And he's not only the center of power, he's the head of all principalities and power. That means I'm also on top. All you need to understand is your position in Christ. And then by the Spirit, use the name. Use the name. These are the things that teach us in Bible school. You know, we have 6 weeks of deliverance starting from tomorrow. Those who have registered, I guarantee you a blessed time in the Holy Ghost. You will never be the same again. This is a Bible school you've never seen. I know we've had classes, but this one, you will testify. Truths that I will share with you. Power that will be made available on Zoom. You have never experienced it before. Believe you me. I'm so equipped spiritually. It's starting tomorrow. Is it tomorrow? 20th. For 6 weeks, every Saturday. If you're not registered, there are numbers on the screen, and you can ask the pastors how to be part of it. I would strongly advise, don't miss this Bible school. First session is deliverance. The one for September is foundation. This is a very important class. This is where champions are made. And we are just handling deliverance. And these are some of the truths that I'll put in your spirit. You know, these are not things we speak every day. Take for an example, Acts chapter 3. Let's look at it. Acts chapter 3. If you've not registered, register now. Call. The numbers are on the screen. Join the school. It's a Zoom class. So whether in Japan, Kuwait, Congo, Paris, US, you can be a student. And experience the fullness of God these 6 weeks. It's only once a week, every Saturday. Classes are from 4 to 6. I guarantee you heaven on earth. I tell you about the Spirit. After this class, you realize the supremacy of the name of Christ over all. And you will see how Satan, is so weak once you understand the place of Christ in your life and your place in him. It's very powerful. It's very powerful. In fact, one of the places in the curriculum that we've prepared, I'll teach you how to rise into demonic planes and meet them at their own game. It's very powerful. This class, if you have never had before, those who've registered, because I've seen quite a number of you have registered, I promise you in the name of the Lord, a blessed time in the Spirit. A blessed time, I tell you the truth. Let's look at an example. We are, point number four, please don't forget, we are now handling the benefits of the Spirit where? In our lives. Number one, the discernment ministry of the Spirit. Number two, the revelation ministry of the Spirit. Number three,
he communicates spiritual things.
The one who communicates the realities of the Spirit. Number four, he helps the believer to use the name of Jesus appropriately and effectively. Why the name of Jesus? Because he is the fullness of all. Now, an example is Acts chapter 3. Peter and John go to prayer. And then they enter the gate called Beautiful. Now, they didn't say, Holy Spirit heal you. Holy Spirit heals you. No. They said, in the name of Jesus, rise up and walk. And then when they were apprehended by the council and the elders of the city, they said, by his name, through faith, is it verse 16? And in his name, through faith in his name, does this man stand here whole? Have you found it? Acts chapter 3, verse 16. Yes.
He says, and his name through faith.
And his name
through faith.
Through faith.
In his name.
In his name.
Has made this man strong.
Has made this man strong.
Who you see and know.
Who you see.
Yeah, the faith which by him
the
has
faith
given
which
him
by
this
him
perfect soundness.
Has given this man perfect soundness in the presence of you all. The name gave the man health. But the power behind the name was the Spirit. Once you understand that everything is in the name of Jesus, but you need the Holy Ghost to administer that name, the power in that name, you're free. You're free. You stop putting responsibility on God and you start taking your place as a priest in this kingdom. God is not the one who determines how far you'll go. Your priesthood determines how you legislate your issues in the realm of life. And all this is by the power and in the power that is in the name of Jesus. I think I'll pick it up from there on Sunday. I need to demystify this thing about the name of the Holy Ghost. But there's a chapter in my book, The Power and the Name of Jesus, that I write the name and the Holy Spirit and the name. You need to read that chapter over and over and over until your understanding blossoms. Someone getting blessed? Amen. Rise up on your feet. Speak in tongues. Don't whisper. Speak in tongues. As you're standing, speak. Open your mouth. Don't whisper. I'm telling you the truth. Something happens when your mouth opens, or spirit man is released into dimensions of revelations. Don't whisper, speak in tongues. Nama katadada. Shede blakata rabanda lagoskeda. Shiga prezo prokanta la barabasko. Adon subriske deleshko brakaya maazos. Iendo bosupla karadesko shanta lamas. Zelemento bragata liza gashkas. Aratubre kobros talabre karish komanaska. Mazule maregedeske de gash. Inzo blakro prosoko proketenela. Makande bakulagaska diakush kenele. Mandros caprese. Shkene ngahaz. Ngahaz. Ngahangres koshkodole. Aropo koponda bahagada. Open up your spirit by speaking in tongues. Open up your spirit to the Holy Ghost. Open up your spirit to the Holy Ghost by speaking in tongues. Setaya, soketengene, edegadagada, shkoros, maliras kanas, elabres kalia mahas, jubokoto. Speak, 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 speak in tongues. Don't whisper it, speak it. Open your mouth so that you can release your spirit. Satalamanda. Zelendo robosh kalias, rekaya mankadas, liku zelega sanish, gero balagri salagas, skenemanga adagala bragaos kodegeske imamba bababura bababoro bobo peregeske degesko zule 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 zolo ragis shage eba barara kapragos kapana. Speak in tongues. Open yourself to the Spirit. Open yourself to the Spirit. As you speak in tongues, you're opening yourself to the Spirit. Shakatayama. Kandabalakorias. Shakatalizo. Ria masanka yadala balagaska. Borodos kiprada asida. Open yourself to the Spirit by speaking. By speaking. By speaking. By speaking in tongues. Open yourself. Not only to the Holy Ghost, but to the realm of the Spirit. As you speak in tongues, your spirit man begins to open itself up into the realm of the supernatural. Continue. Setene, zaliga daba yada, jado, lakradas kanuz, ima, manama, namanama, malagrato, mala, prezo brokerebe, marando, sagasha, gayege, tekiza, yagada, aprazo kapania maha, sakas, 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 sakas. Saka, saka, adiga, agadabala, agadabara. Pro se katambara baboro redegeske. Zioto, ziema, zaisho, bagaske, agadaba. Open yourself up in the Holy Ghost. Continue. Continue. Santolo baranda rababara bakaya manda. Seto boyanda la brakara mayanda. Hey, continue. Open until you begin to see visions and dreams. Open your spirit now by speaking in tongues. Until you begin to see your tomorrow. Until you begin to hear him say something. Kera baba baba baba. Manga da baba la baba la baba. Babora baba bombri na baruske. Jika tobre kaladra sana. Mazule lekrobo karadia ahas. Ahangora bahari ya bahorias. Pongo pongo poruse tas. Ashko. Skenda la brekora babes. Lima yasha la hala mahangaras. Shedele mehegezos uzangashke dego okondo bagada gela abila balaga daria arangria gaseko. Go deeper, go deeper, go deeper, go deeper, go deeper, go deeper in the Spirit. Open yourself up, open your spirit up by speaking in tongues. Bosh kadaba ile baba baba solobre karabayan ula baba baba barabos kontesku rizoboshana aziando besula bahada ubra kombra gasa libre eskuloba bazila bazila lakas bazila malekana bazale kropira bayana buze buze degesho da kontro zonta libra karia mozo doboshkede. Continue, 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 continue. Skenda bahandas, skanda bahash kodohoras, ishinda lahanara bahal kazua bahas, azatela balakanala balagadolos, jedira glas kapras kaprio kodoske, ketobo kada. Open yourself up. Please pray the Holy Ghost. Speak. Open yourself to the Spirit of God. Well. Do it well. Do it well. Don't whisper. You will make a big mistake whispering. You need to open your mouth so that your spirit man opens up. Shantama. Online. are seated in a hotel somewhere, open your mouth and speak in other tongues. Open your spirit to the Holy Ghost. Go deeper, go deeper, go deeper. Go deeper, go deeper, go deeper. Jesus. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Salana. Saliba lala mandro, saliba. Lakrados kamish kubalagada mahas. Malahas, malahas, malahara bambu. Babira barangros korebeshe dela. Barako pros kaparia mahas. Emma mahas. Sakala bralkas. Jesus. Ede baba baba baba. Jesus. Emma baba baba baba. Jesus. Okodoko. Okodoko kede bagina bagada ba. Jesus. Saka. Rekopo kapaya mahara bohoskede. Eduba. Adagadaske de kashkira. Ebraka karako podale para. Stretch forth your hands towards the altar. I pray for a fresh unction of the Spirit upon your life. A fresh unction of the Spirit upon your life. A fresh unction of the Spirit upon your life. A fresh unction of the Holy Ghost upon your life. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Keep your hands up and thank God for this service. On the name, thank Him for the word and for the impartation of the Spirit. Learn to open your mouth. Don't. Spiritual things are not whispered. You speak. You vocalize it. You put sound into your belief. Word becomes spirit. Thank God. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' blessed name. You may be seated. Are you blessed by these truths? Are you blessed by this truth? Keep the keyboards going. Are you blessed by these truths? Are you truly blessed? Go back and watch this again, minimum 7 times. Until your spirit connects with the message. And you begin to hear what I did not say. And you begin to write when you're alone what you did not write in church. You hear and hear and hear until you begin to hear on the inside. Are you catching the flow? These truths will make you more than a champion. By the way, on Tuesday, all pastors, leaders, heads of departments, you have a business, you're a leader in your own capacity, don't miss the breakfast meeting here. It's free. Just come and eat. But more so, carry your iPad, your notebook, and a prepared spirit. In fact, on Tuesday, after teaching, I will impart spiritual gifts unto us. I will impart that which will make your business, your ministry, your place of influence. I will impart that which will make that place work. Just 2 hours, 9 a.m. to 11. Tuesday, don't miss. It's on the 23rd. 23rd, so a breakfast for leaders. But Sunday, this coming Sunday, is still Holy Ghost and prayer banquet. First service, second service, 8:30, 10:30. And we're on this journey for 10 good days. And you know, Sunday in the evening, I'll have a special online program just to speak spirit to us. Sunday after service, we'll have an online service. Online, so it won't be on ground. It's the other Sunday that we have on ground. Is it 28th or the other Sunday? The other Sunday is when we have healing and deliverance. Is actually, the Holy Ghost keeps saying it's a prayer meeting. Yeah. Anytime I talk about it, the Holy Ghost keeps saying it's a prayer meeting. So that 28th afternoon is a healing deliverance service prayer meeting. God wants to meet with us that Sunday on the altar of prayer. Come ready. Come ready. Come ready for your miracle. Next Sunday at 3 p.m. we'll have our first 2 services, and then afternoon is a special
pray healing and deliverance prayer meeting. See what God will do here on the 28th. It's going to be awesome. Now, get your blessedness out. Please, catch it. I didn't say offering because I really, when it's offering, is a religious way of doing it. Get your blessedness. The response of your spirit. How blessed have you been blessed in this service? That's the response now. Respond spiritually with your material goods. Respond. So don't give based on, you know, this thing I give based on what I have. It's not Bible. Giving is a spiritual thing. It's worship. You give based on how your spirit has been blessed. You're responding. Worship is the response of the human spirit to God and His word. Do it well. On the net, I keep telling you, it is an error. After you're watching and then you say, no one sees me, you actually come out very quickly. You don't even wait for offering time. Very quickly, say, amen, chwa, 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 chwa. It's the reason why you are where you are. You have to complete this act of worship by honoring God. Not only by your giving, but by your response of the Spirit through your giving. Your giving should show how blessed you are. It's a response. That's what we call worship. The details are on the screen. Let me start with Titus. As you package your blessedness, you're paying your tithe. You're offering your fast fruits, whether on the net or on ground. Please rise up. I want to bless you. In the name of Jesus. Father, thank you for the tithers, the fast fruiters. Lord, bless them and increase them in every way in Jesus' name. Remain standing until the ushers collect your tithes. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. You're lifted for life. God bless you. God bless you. Now let's all rise with our blessedness. This Friday breakthrough service. And just lift it up and thank God for such a powerful impartation of the Spirit in the name of Jesus. Just thank God from the depth of your heart. Thank Him. Thank Him from the depth of your heart. Thank Him from the depth of your heart. Thank Him from the depth of your heart. Come on, just lift up your offerings, your blessedness. Thank Him from the depth of your heart. Thank Him from the depth of your heart. Thank Him from the depth of your heart. Thank Him from the depth of your heart.
Thank you, Jesus. Father, we thank you. Lord, we give you praise. Thank you.
Lion of Judah, my trust.
Reverend Joseph Matko has just given you the key for a progressive life in Jesus Christ. We believe that your life will never be the same again. It cannot be otherwise. Please share with us your testimony. To reach Reverend Joseph Matko, please call 022-524-626 or email info@miracleLifeAssembly.org. God bless you.
I put a money, oh yeah, my trust.